Shakshuka is a traditional Middle Eastern breakfast that literally means a mixture. It's packed with flavour and my one is dead simple. It all starts with chopped garlic and oil. So cooking up the garlic till it's just kind of a light brown, and then I'm going to add some spring onion. Season and add a spoonful of tomato puree. It's got a rich, deep, concentrated flavour of tomato that you don't get with just tomatoes alone. So that is perfect. It's cooked down. You can see all the tomatoes are kind of like all mushy. That only takes a few minutes. And now I'm going to add my spices. I've got my smoked paprika. I love this stuff. Oh my goodness, I put this in everything. And then I'm going to add some cumin seeds. And now I'm going to add my spinach. Right now, this is when the kids come running in and they'll say they want to crack the eggs in, but not today. I'm going to leave the fun bit for me. And I just pop the lid on. It'll just take a few minutes for the whites of the eggs to poach. It's the perfect moment to toast some bread. And this is a great way to do toast. On a griddle. Ow, burn your fingers. And look at that. That's got like rich, smoky spinach sauce around the outside. And the egg whites have just cooked, just poached. But the yolks, I can see, are still runny. And that is perfect. And then just to finish it off, I like to add just a sprinkling of chili flakes. This is such a good way to start our morning, making sure that it's given us enough fuel for the rest of the day. Smoky spinach shakshuka, the perfect start to a wind-down weekend. Chaat is a popular street snack in Bangladesh. It's crunchy, sweet, tangy, spicy, and totally delicious. My chaat has two sauces. For an easy mint sauce, mix 200 grams of mayonnaise, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, and the same of dried mint. Now there's no way I can put the top on that and squeeze that mayonnaise out without a little bit of a fight. What I want is a sauce that I can squeeze out so it's a little bit runny. So I'm gonna add a bit of milk. That sounds about right. You've all squeezed some sauce out of a bottle. You know what you're looking for. The tamarind sauce is even easier. Mix together 200 grams of tomato sauce and 4 teaspoons of tamarind paste. Mmm. And now for the extra bits to throw into the bag. I have never had a chaat where there is no onion. Always, always onion. I mean, I don't like super spicy food. This is why something like this works perfectly for me, because if I ask my husband to make mine, it will blow my head off. The coriander, the chilies, the onions, they all feel very traditional. Just to make it a little bit different, I've got some roasted salted peanuts and I've got some crispy fried onions. That is the making of my chaat. That's it. All I have to do now is actually show you how I make it. I like to use tortilla chips, which are my kids' favourite. It's a fun bit. Makes me feel like a street vendor. What would you like, sir? Throw in all the toppings. Mmm, love coriander. And finish with loads of sauce. You need a fork for this. Just when you thought crisps couldn't get any better, they just did. My chaat in a bag, a favourite with everyone. Nothing beats us all sitting down to my burgers with bacon jam. The kids love them, and they're a big hit with the grown-ups too. I've got a recipe for a really good bacon jam that works so well in a burger, in toast, crumpets. But in a burger, it is... Ugh.
Start by frying chopped garlic and onion.
Now, I don't eat bacon, but thank the Lord someone found an alternative. And this stuff looks like bacon, and I think it might even taste a little bit like bacon. So this is turkey bacon.
But of course, you can use the real stuff if you like. For heat, throw in some chili flakes.
So now, this is kind of more like the jam bit. I've got some brown sugar in a jug, and then to that, I'm going to add a tablespoon of instant coffee granules. It seems like such an unusual thing to do. Something about the coffee brings out that smokiness of the bacon, which really works, and I tried it without the coffee, not so good.
Pour in 125 mils of hot water.
That is the strongest thing you'll ever drink. Just to finish off my jam, I'm going to add some vinegar and then some maple syrup. And maple and bacon, that's a really classic combination. And I want to let that cook down on a gentle heat for about an hour.
While that cooks down, I can get on with the burger patties. Start by adding 1 tablespoon of garlic granules to 1 kilogram of beef mince. Then a teaspoon of onion salt.
And then lots and lots and lots of black pepper. At least like a teaspoon's worth. So I'm gonna get my hands straight in and give that a really good mix.
They'll need around 5 minutes each side to get them nice and crispy on the outside and juicy on the inside.
Yeah, look at that. Look at that, you see all those crispy bits? Oh. Burger needs a good slab of cheese, and this is smoked cheese. And this stuff is great because it kind of complements the already smoky bacon. Melt cheese, melt. Right, now, the other little bit that I like on our burgers is a runny egg. It's on my patty, beef patty with my cheese. Everything is in that burger. It's sweet, it's salty, it's tangy, it's a little bit sour. Oh.
I like my crumble with more fruit and less crumble. And these individual pear crumbles are the perfect dessert to show off when you have people to stay. First, peel the pears. Leaving the stalks on, cut the pears in half.
So I'm gonna poach my pears in apple juice. The first time I saw pears being poached, it was on television and it was in red wine. Now, I don't drink, so it doesn't mean I can't have a poached pear. So this is my alternative if you don't drink.
With the pears bubbling in the apple juice, split a vanilla pod and add to the mix. Make sure you use all the seeds.
So I've got the gas on and I'm gonna let these boil and simmer for about 30 minutes. And as the pears boil, all the apple juice is gonna kind of permeate into the rest of the pears and make them lovely and soft. So I'm gonna leave that and then I'm gonna make my crumble.
Add 50 grams of plain flour and 25 grams of butter.
I'm rubbing my butter into my flour. So you've got these lovely buttery, floury clumps, which is perfect.
25 grams of demerara sugar and 100 grams of granola. Add sweetness and crunch.
So my crumble's ready. Just gonna check if my pears are cooked. They're lovely and soft in the middle, which is perfect. I'm gonna turn that off. So my pears have cooled and I'm just gonna fish them out. Before I do anything else to the pears, what I want to do is make a syrup out of the apple juice and the vanilla. I don't want to throw any of it away. That's worked really hard to kind of poach my pears, and I want to keep every last bit of it. So I'm going to turn the heat back up.
150 grams of demerara sugar will transform the juice into a delicious syrup for the crumble. Scoop out the inside of the pears and fill the holes with balls of marzipan.
If you don't like marzipan on your fruitcake, try cooking marzipan when it's hot and gooey and almondy. Then you'll change your mind about marzipan.
Put the pears into a dish and carefully place the crumble onto each half. Bake in the oven for 20 minutes at 180 degrees. and make sure you keep an eye on the apple syrup.
It doesn't look like a crumble, but it is. You've got that lovely, soft apple poached pear, and then my gorgeous apple caramel.
Served with a scoop of ice cream, my half pear crumble is the perfect pudding to give to your friends and family when they visit.